फिजिक्स क्लास 12 चैप्टर 8 इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट आईडी द करंट ड्यू टू चेंजिंग इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड और इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज कॉल्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट आईडी और मैक्सवेल डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट दिस इज अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट इन चैप्टर 4 मूविंग चार्जेस एंड मैग्नेटिज्म वी स्टडीड दैट इलेक्ट्रिक करंट प्रोड्यूसेस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड अराउंड इट Oersted experiment. When Oersted performed the experiment, he found that there was a magnetic needle placed near the current carrying wire. When the current was flowing in this wire, the magnetic needle was deflected. When the direction of the current was changed, the deflection also was changed. So he concluded that the current which is flowing in this wire is producing the magnetic field around it. This we have studied in chapter 4. Consider a parallel plate capacitor C connected to a circuit. So this is my capacitor C connected to the circuit. I of t is time dependent, current flows through it. So current is flowing from here, I of t, which is depending on the time. For magnetic field at point P outside the capacitor place, let us consider a plain circular loop of radius r whose plane is perpendicular to the current carrying wire. Our aim is to find the magnetic field at point P, which is just outside the place of the capacitor at this point P. So what we are going to consider? We consider a loop whose radius is r. Now the loop is perpendicular to the wire. So loop is in this direction, okay, and the wire is in this direction. Wire is this direction, loop is in this direction. Now you should consider a small element of this loop, dl. Okay, this dl, if I consider this dl, then we know by right hand thumb rule, if current is flowing in this direction, then magnetic field will be in this direction. And this dl also is in this direction. So magnetic field is in this direction, dl also this direction. That means they both are parallel to each other. By Ampere's circuital law, integral BdL is equal to mu naught I of t. Now, B dot dl can be written as BdL cos theta is equal to mu naught I of t integral as it is. Now, B parallel to dl, that means theta equal to 0 and cos 0 is 1. Now, B is same on the surface of the loop. So, B is a constant, take out of the integral. So, B integral dl equal to mu naught I of t. Now this integral dl is nothing but circumference of the circle, because this is the loop, this is the area, this element of this loop is this dl, and if you consider all these small elements and you combine together, integrate together, it will give you the circumference which is given by 2 pi r. So put this integral dl as 2 pi r. This 2 pi r you transfer over here, you get b is equal to mu naught I of t divided by 2 pi r, call it number 1. Now consider a different surface from figure B, which has same boundary. This is a pot-like surface which nowhere touches the current but has its bottom between the place of capacitor. Its mouth is circular loop. Now look at this second figure. Okay, here we are going to consider a circular loop. Now this circular loop is passing from the between the place of the capacitor. It doesn't touch the current anywhere, and we'll apply the Ampere's circuital law. Integral BdL is equal to mu naught I. Since no current passes through surface I equal to 0. So put I equal to 0, so mu naught into 0, which gives you 0. And integral dl, b is a constant, and integral dl will be 2 pi r. So 2 pi r transfer here, so 0 by anything is 0, so b is equal to 0, call it number 2. Now we have found from equation 1, b value at point P, mu naught I of t, 2 pi r. And from equation 2, b value of b at point P equal to 0. So one answer is this, one answer is this. Both are different answers. So what we can say is, from equation 1 and 2, there is a contradiction which arises from the use of Ampere's circuital law. Therefore, this law must be missing something. Since there is a contradiction, so we can say that something is missing in the law which we have used here. And that missing term we have to find. That missing term is nothing but your displacement current, which we have to find now. Let capital A be the area and capital Q be the charge on the place of capacitor. Then the magnitude of electric field E between the place is given by E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. What is sigma? Sigma is surface charge density given by Q by A. Put the value of sigma, Q by A, and this epsilon naught as it is, call it number 3. By Gauss law, electric flux phi E is equal to magnitude of electric field into A. From equation 3, put the value of E, that is this one, Q by epsilon naught into A. So I put here, and this A as it is, cut AA, so we get Q by epsilon naught. If charge Q on place of capacitor changes with time, then there is a current. So if Q on the capacitor place changes, then there will be current. So we shall differentiate this equation because Q is changing, so I differentiate this with respect to T, that is time. So let us differentiate both the sides. So when you differentiate phi, you get d phi e by dt is equal to this 1 by epsilon naught is constant. So just keep as it is, 1 by epsilon naught, and differentiate phi, sorry, q with respect to t, that is dq by dt. But dq by dt is nothing but the current, that is I, and epsilon naught you transfer over here. So you get epsilon naught d phi e by dt is equal to I. And this is the term which is missing in Ampere circuital law. This is the term missing in Ampere circuital law. So therefore, the total current is I is equal to IC plus ID. What is IC? IC is called conduction current. And how we define? It is a current carried by conductor through the flow of charges. And ID is the displacement current. The generalized law is integral BDL is equal to mu naught I. I is the current, that is IC plus ID. Put the value of I from here, IC plus ID. And ID is from here, epsilon naught d phi e by dt. Put this value of ID, mu, IC as it is. So mu naught IC plus epsilon naught d phi e by dt. Mu naught multiply inside, so you get mu naught IC plus mu naught epsilon naught d phi e by dt. And this side is integral BDL. And this equation is known as Ampere-Maxwell law. Now, electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. This is the place of the capacitor. This is positively charged, this is negatively charged. We know that electric field starts from the positive and terminate at the negative. So electric field is in this direction, okay, from here, from plus to minus, so this direction. The red arrows shows the electric field, and the magnetic field will be in this direction, perpendicular. Okay, it will be perpendicular in the circular. This green line you can see, green circle, that is the magnetic field. Now suppose this electric field which is shown in this direction, suppose you show it in going inside the board, okay, this I have shown by cross. Cross means it is going inside the board, so the electric field is going inside the board and the magnetic field will be in the circular. So you can see here electric field is going inside the board and the magnetic field is like this. That means this is like, electric field is like this, magnetic field is like this. That means they are perpendicular to each other. So electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. So we'll keep this much for today. Thank you very much.